So, I know a lot of you in London have been using Uber. How do you feel about that? It's like a great, epic, historic battle between the black cab drivers and the Uber drivers. Kind of reminds me of the plot of American Gods. It's like the old kind of amazing, kind of mythical thing versus the new, modern, convenient, shiny, but possibly very dangerous thing. I wanted to tell you guys a story about so I had this friend, Melissa, and in San Francisco, and she went to a party one night, and she called an Uber to take her from the party back home. She's alone, and it was late, but not crazy late. And she got in the Uber, and she kind of got distracted and checked her Facebook and checked her email, and she's in the back seat for a while. And then I got a text from her, and I was, you know, in a different time zone. I was in New York, so it was a little earlier for me. And she sent me this text saying, "I'm freaking out. I don't think this Uber is taking me home." And she sent me a screenshot. And the party was here, and her house was here, and the Uber had taken her here. And she was like, what do I do? And I was like, well, can you just jump out? And she texted back, no, we're on the highway. There's no way I can jump out. We're going 60 miles an hour. And she took a screenshot of the Uber profile, and I waited, and I sort of texted her and comforted her, and then another 5 or 10 minutes went by, and she texted and she said, okay, we've exited and coming up to a red light. I'm gonna jump out. And I texted back, good luck. But then I got scared myself because I didn't hear from her. And a couple minutes went by and I was kind of freaking out, and I didn't hear from her and I didn't hear from her. And 5 minutes went by and I texted her and I said, what happened? Are you okay? What's going on? Nothing. And then I got a picture. And the picture is just, it looks like a photograph of just the ground, the side of the highway. Just pavement and dirt. And I was like, oh, that's creepy. And then I saw those little writing dots. And I got a text that said, Melissa's fine. And I texted back, like, what's going on? Who is this? What's happening? And I didn't get anything back. And I waited. And I was really creeped out at this point. And nothing came in, and then like 5 minutes later, I got another photo. And it was another photograph of the ground. And a shoe. And then a text. It said, Lewis is not fine. Can you come and pick us up?
I am sinking in the grave. It is not night.
somewhere on the telly in the middle of the road. This story can't be finished, 'cause this picture still won't load. They say that I'm not breathing, but I simply don't believe them. And as soon as this is working, I'll make him take me home. Home.
Switch damn phone on.